Sinterklaas feest allemaal. What I just said was happy, basically. Happy Sinterklaas Day. As you guys know now, I live in the Netherlands. And today is a special day for kids in the Netherlands. Although, I think there might be a few adults who indulge anyway. It's mostly a kids thing though. And it is Sinterklaas Day. So, for those of you who don't know, is a fair amount because it's a very specific to the Netherlands and Belgium, is the idea of Santa Claus, which we have in North America and in a couple other countries, I believe, doesn't exist the same way in Belgium and the Netherlands. Correct me if I'm wrong, people who are from that region, but I think I should be saying Flanders. That's not entirely true, but it's intended to be as an exclusively religious holiday. Everyone gets it off work, like in North America, but it's not a gift-giving holiday. It's a day where you go to church and you sing hymns and carols and you've got your Christmas tree, but there are no presents involved. Instead, they have Sinterklaas Day, which is December 5th. This is a day where Sinterklaas, or Sint, gives presents to kids. And instead of stockings, they use shoes, or schoenen. So, because I'm not an expert on this, I've only been here a year, although I do remember my Grammy, when she was still alive, telling me about it. I'm half Dutch, so the Dutch side of my family kind of, like, she always had Sinterklaas decorations up around Christmas. But apart from that, I'm far from an expert. So I have this article here about Sinterklaas, and you can consider this kind of like a facts video. And I will read it to you so you can learn a bit more about this Benelux holiday and how they separate the Santa Claus and gift giving into instead of having it all in one on Christmas. So here we go. Have you ever heard of Sinterklaas or Saint Nicholas? It is the most appreciated holiday by kids in the Netherlands and Belgium, and is a bit similar to Father Christmas. For starters, there wouldn't even have been a Santa Claus in this world if it weren't for Sinterklaas. The appearance and role of Mr. Claus is in fact largely based on his skinny Dutch cousin. Celebrated by the Dutch each year on December. is mostly famous for bringing joy, cheer, and gifts to well-behaved kids. In late November, a few weeks before his actual birthday, the good man sails in from Spain by boat. His arrival is a festive and happy occasion that all children eagerly anticipate. This is followed by a procession through the streets while his pitas shower the waiting children with candies and tiny brown cookies called papernote, or sometimes they use krautnote, but usually papernote. Up until his birthday celebration, children leave their shoes near the fireplace at night and fill them with hay and carrots for Sinterklaas' horse. Must be found the next morning, unless the child has been naughty, in which case it will receive a note that if he or she doesn't clean up his or her act, there will be no presents on December 5th. And even worse, Sinterklaas may take the child with him back to Spain in his burlap sack. And then, on the evening of December 5th, we enter the grand finale. There is banging on the front door and on the windows, but when the children open the door, there's nobody there. Instead, they find a heap of presents in burlap bags. As the children grow older, by age 8 or 9, they have found out by accident presents in mommy's closet or drawings mailed to the Sint, or on purpose, classmates have spilled the secret, that the whole concept of Sinterklaas is in fact one big scam and that parents have been deceiving them for years. Some find this utterly dramatic, probably from fear that the yearly stream of presents will dry up, and others find it exciting to be let in on this grown-up secret. Now that the secret's out, it doesn't mean that the traditions stop. It is still celebrated by many bigger kids and grown-ups, although the rules change a little. But now, you will enter the era of surprises. Everyone draws a person's name and is obliged to craft something spectacular for this present that hides the gift. The messier, the better, and the more difficult to extract the hidden gift, the more hilarious and successful you'll be. And of course, there should be a personalized poem that should be funny, witty, and daunting at the same time. All this is in good cheer, and most families keep up the Sinterklaas tradition for many years to come. Which doesn't mean the Dutch and Belgians don't celebrate Christmas, because they do. Which brings us back to where we started. Sinterklaas and Santa Claus are basically one and the same character, as you've learned by now. Santa originally was Sinterklaas at first, but evolved into a closely related, but altogether completely different character. Since lean and very skinny posture is no competition for Santa's big rounded belly, it might influence also how both are perceived. It looks like Cousin Claus is a much more easygoing and jollier character than the Sint, who hardly laughs and seems a bit detached. Father Christmas does not punish children, but Sint threatens to do so. Santa Claus transports himself in a magic sleigh, has elf helpers, and a known address where he manufactures his toys and gifts. He comes down the chimney just like Pete, but leaves his presents in a stocking instead of a shoe. On the big day at sunrise, presents can be found under the Christmas tree, and Santa has a wife, which the Sint doesn't, probably because of his saintly background and celibacy stuff. So there you go. Saint and Santa both sprouted from the legendary tales of the Bishop from Myra, but evolved into two different characters with an identical mission, that of bringing joy and happiness to kids all over the world. So that's the end of the article. And having experienced one Sinterklaas day before this one, I can say that it's relatively accurate. I mean, obviously I didn't grow up with as a kid, so I can't speak to the parts about the kids' arrive, or the kids' tradition, so like the shoes and the